Hello world, this is Prashant and I am going to talk about Apache Spark. Apache Spark doesn't need an introduction, so I am not going to talk about what it is, what can you do using Apache Spark, and why should you learn it. We will directly start learning. So, where do we start? What is the first step? Set up your environment and get access to the latest and greatest version of Apache Spark. There are many ways to do this, and I will cover some convenient and modern methods. In this video, I will cover the fastest and easiest approach to set up your learning environment. We will set up a standalone Spark on your local machine. We'll go further and integrate Jupyter Notebook for Scala, Python, and Spark SQL. I'll execute one simple example to show you the whole process. If you are new to notebooks, don't worry, I'll cover that as well. Great, let's start. You need a Linux machine with JDK 8 installed. You can download latest JDK RPM from Oracle TechNet and install it using yum. If you don't have a Linux machine, check out my Google Cloud tutorial. You can get a free VM on cloud. Let's download the Apache Spark. You can pick up the latest version pre-built for Apache Hadoop. Download this zip file. Installation is as simple as extracting the contents of the file. That's it, we installed Apache Spark standalone. If you check the directory, you should see something like this. Remember this location. The absolute path of this directory is your Spark home. Let me set it up to an environment variable. Let me add this to my path variable as well. Spark home and then bin. That's where all the executables are laid. Great, we are ready to start learning Spark. We really don't need anything else. This setup is enough for learning purpose. You can start Spark shell. Load some data. Execute some queries. Well, you don't like the Scala way? Do it SQL way. Like it? No? You want Python? No worries. Press Ctrl D. Let's do it in Python. Load some data. You wanna do it SQL way? You can do that as well. Great. Did you notice that Scala syntax and Python syntax are almost same? That's because Spark is a language in itself. We will learn more about it as we progress. I will try to cover Scala and Python both. But I still recommend that you learn Scala. Check out my Scala tutorials. Okay, I showed you item 1, 2 and 3. The next three things are to configure a notebook for your Spark. Notebooks are already popular. If you haven't used it earlier, you might be wondering with following questions. What are they and why should I bother about them? The Jupyter Notebook is an interactive computing environment that enables user to author notebook documents using a web interface. These documents are not a dumb text document. You can include following things in a notebook: live running code, interactive widgets, plots and graphs, narrative text, images and videos. So, whatever examples, source code, plots, graphs and some text that I am going to use in my Scala tutorials, I can publish it as a notebook for you. You can use it, execute it as it is, modify it and also add your comments and notes inline. You will realize the benefits as soon as you start seeing it live in this tutorial. Great. Let's install Jupyter Notebook. Go to the Jupyter website and you will notice that they recommend installing Anaconda. Anaconda is an open source Python distribution and it comes bundled with many things including Jupyter. You install Anaconda and you get Jupyter as well. So, download Anaconda for Linux. You can install it by executing following command. Press enter to continue. Do you accept the license? Yes. Where do you want to install it? The default location is my home directory. Good. I am fine with that. Press enter. Do you want to add it to path environment variable? Yes, do it please. Thank you. Done. We have Jupyter, but we need a Jupyter kernel to integrate Jupyter with Spark. As on date, we have couple of options. Spark Magic and Apache Tori. I will use Apache Tori. The latest version of Tori is 0.1. It doesn't work with Spark 2. So, I will download the updated dev build. Installing Tori is a two-step process. Add Tori to pip. Install Tori kernel into Jupyter. We are going to configure Scala, Python and Spark SQL. The last option --user is to restrict the installation for the current user. If you don't give this option, you might end up in permission related problems. Great, done. Now all that we need to do is to start a Jupyter notebook. If you are using a local machine, you can start Jupyter notebook using this command. The default IP is the local host and default port is 8888. The last option is to make sure that Jupyter doesn't automatically launch a browser. Copy this URL and paste it into your browser. That's it. Done. But this simple command doesn't work for me because I am using a VM in Google Cloud. So, I have two extra steps. Upgrade my external IP address to a static IP and add a firewall rule to open TCP 8888 port. Let's do that. While your GCP VM is running, go to your VPC networks, click on external IP address. Change the type to static. It will ask you a name, just give some name. The next thing is to add a firewall rule. Create a firewall rule. Give a tag name. Open TCP 8888 port. Save it. Now we need to apply this tag to our VM instance. Shut down your VM. And implement the firewall tag. Start your VM. Done. I have to do all these extra steps because I am using Google VPC network. If you are new to Google VPC networks, check out my Google Cloud tutorials. Great! Now we are ready to start the Jupyter Notebook. Start the Jupyter Notebook using this command. The Jupyter server will give you a URL. Copy that URL. Change the IP address to your VM's external static IP address and paste it into your browser. That's it. This page is your default landing area. It shows you the files and directories from your current working directory. You can start a new Scala notebook from here. But before that, let me give you a quick introduction to the Jupyter notebook. A Jupyter notebook is a live document. It works in two modes, edit mode and command mode. The notebook area is composed of cells. The one you see here is a cell. When my cursor is blinking here and you see this edit mode indicator, you are in edit mode. You can type whatever you want. When you have finished typing, press escape key. You will change to command mode. The cell border will change to gray. The gray border indicates that you are in command mode. Press enter or click using the mouse and you will come back to the edit mode. Come back to command mode and press 4, the numeric 4. The cell becomes a level 4 heading. To insert a new cell, press B from your keyboard. Press enter key to switch to edit mode and type something. Press escape key to come back to command mode. Press M from your keyboard. You change the current cell to markdown. I hope you know markdown, right? It is a superset of HTML. So, this cell is now a HTML text. Add another cell and type some Scala code. Come back to command mode. Press Ctrl Enter. The Ctrl Enter will execute the current cell and show you the output as well. Add another line and some more code. Execute it. Amazing, isn't it? You can create a document that contains an HTML formatted text, a live running code, and the output as well. It may take a couple of days to get familiar with notebook interface. You can get a list of all your keyboard shortcuts from here. You can access how to use Jupyter notebooks at this URL. Now the best part. The entire tutorial, all the commands, code examples, and document steps are available to you as a Jupyter notebook. You can access my GitHub account, clone and download the entire repository. You want to download a single notebook? Follow these steps. Copy the notebook URL from GitHub. Open NB Viewer. Paste the GitHub link and press Go. Download the notebook file. Once you have the .ipynb file, upload it to your Jupyter Notebook repository. That's it. You have a fully documented tutorial with a running code. Do you want to help me? You can do following. Share and like my YouTube videos. The most important thing is to share it with your groups. Give a star to my GitHub repository. You want to be up to date with the new tutorials? Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Watch my GitHub repository. Thank you for watching Learning Journal. Keep learning and keep growing.